I love this game.
Watching my grandson's eyes light up.
The music.
Take me out.
Hot dogs.
Peanuts.
To the ball game.
I love coming to the stadium.
I love hot dogs too.
Do they have cotton candy?
A 400-foot shot.
Spending time with my family.
I love going with Daddy.
There's something here for everyone.
It's game time.
For promos and tickets, visit liducks.com.
This is Long Island Ducks Hot Stove.
And welcome to Long Island Ducks Hot Stove. It is great to be back here at the studio. Nice and warm here. We have a lot of stuff to talk about. So we're just going to get right into it right now, right here. Here we go. First topic is the last weekend's episode. Now, it was a long episode. It was a 30-minute episode, which I do not have the advantage yet to put on YouTube, so I couldn't make it all into one thing. That's why it was all separated. Good thing that everyone listened to the links down below thing and all my annotations and stuff. Thank you, annotations. it was really a good time being there and meeting some fans and meeting the new player, who I will mention in a little bit. But also, one of the main things that I was excited about is getting to interview the one and the only Reyna Rorette.
How do you feel? Feel great.
Yeah, he was a great guy. It was an awesome time interviewing him. Sorry about the technical difficulties with the audio and stuff. It was actually the first time for me using a microphone instead of just using the normal speaker camera. Next time I should be able to get that all fixed up, and that'll be probably next year. But anyways, we have a lot of stuff to talk about that has happened in the last week. There's actually a lot of stuff to talk about the Ducks and all the upcoming events. First, I want to thank all my new followers, all my new people I got to talk to for the at the ticket opening. It was really cool that people were interested about what I was doing. It's kind of odd to see guys set up a camera, apparently, unless they're from TV, internet, or something else. But it was really, really fun. And I got to meet a lot of new people, and a lot of people were coming up to me and like, "Hey man, what are you doing? Hey man, what are you from YouTube, TV?" I'm like, "I'm from YouTube, Duck695. I told them about my channel, whatever. I wasn't able to bring the sign with me, but it was a good time. I had a really good time. I'm going to do it again next year. Hopefully it's a little warm next year, because it really was cold. There was purple all over my hand, so I couldn't feel it for a while. I thought I had to go to the hospital at one point because I lost all feeling in my palm and my hand and stuff. So yeah. But in other news with the Long Island Ducks, we have there's a brand new thing that they're gonna do for this year. As you all know, they do spring training down in Texas. Right before they open up in Texas against the Sugarland Skeeters this year. So, what they are going to do for us, they are going to have a fan fest. Now, a fan fest, if you don't know, is usually during the All-Star break, but we are going to do it in the beginning of the year, because who really cares about, who really cares? It's the Ducks, we're the champions. And this is what they had on news on the news feed for the Long Island Ducks. This is what came up. First ever fan fest will start at 10:30 a.m. on April 13th. Mark that on your calendar. I will be there too. Highlights include saying happy birthday to Quacker Jack, since his birthday just passed, at the Smoking Isles Party Deck. You get to try the all-new dunk tank. There will be the Waddle Inn shop that will be open, and at approximately 12:45 p.m., there will be introductions to the lineup for the 2013 Long Island Ducks before opening day. Now, doesn't mean that this is technically the opening day, but what they're going to do is they're going to have a spring training game at home. Now, that's a big news coming out of the Long Island Ducks, because they never have a spring training game at home open to the public. Now, this is your opportunity to see a spring training game, a preseason game, anything, any way you want to put it at all. Go see it. It's going to be awesome. And special news coming from here, we are going to do highlights. We are going to do our first ever highlight session for the channel. That will be on the 13th of April. Game time is 1:05 p.m. against the Bridgeport Bluefish. There will be a pregame show live from the ballpark. Even though it is just spring training, who cares? We are going to practice the spring training. We're going to practice by doing our spring training. So mark down your calendars. It is coming up very, very soon. I am so excited. I am able to go. As far as I know, tickets are free. The only thing you have to do is come and support your team. That's it. That's all they ask. What else is going on? The Anthem Search is back, and also they're adding on-field hosts and PA announcer. But that doesn't mean that Paul DeGraffo is not going to be the on-field announcer. It just means that they're going to have substitutes just in case that Paul DeGraffo does go on a vacation once again like he did last year. Now, last year, I did not have the opportunity to audition, but I'm kind of leaning towards auditioning. I don't know yet. Information about the Anthem tryouts. It will be Saturday, April 6th at Bethpage 12. Our doors open at 9 o'clock a.m. You will go down to the concourse. You'll have a microphone in your hand, and you get to sing the national anthem in front of Paul DeGraffo and who is this other guy? I don't know who his name is. But he's the promo manager, I'd like to say. Promotion manager, Jordan Scott. Yeah, Jordan. I forgot about Jordan. I actually saw him last week. You can contact Jordan at jshuffin, I hope I pronounced that right, at laducks.com. For if you do want to do some on-field announcing or the PA announcing. One last thing I want to talk about on this channel is that I did not get the job with the Long Island Ducks. I know, I am sorry that they did not pick me. I would have been going to a lot more games, but don't worry, I have worked it out with everyone that I usually go to the games with. We all committed to going to a lot more games this year, so there will be over 21 games that I'll be filming this year. Get that down on your calendar. Over 21 games. 21 last season. Now we're trying to break the record by going to 22 games. That is pretty much it here from the studio. Did not have my whole crew here today. I gave them an off day. I really did want to use the backdrop and that whatever, so I just did it all by myself. I'm going to edit everything by myself just in a little bit. Then I'm going out for the night since to celebrate spring break, which, by the way, we are going to have a... We're going to have a little bit of a delay, I think, in the Long Island Ducks hot stove. I will let you guys know in the next update video, which will come out on Wednesday. So mark down your calendar. Also, Wednesday update video for you guys. Thank you so much for your support. Thank you all so much for being out in the freezing cold last time. It was really fun. I want to thank all the people that got me ready to go, my parents basically, and my whole crew. I got to meet the first fan line, first kin line. I got to meet all of them. They're so nice. They're nice people. thank you all so much for your support, and all I have to say is goodbye, and see you next week on Long Island Doug.
All right, let's...
Long Island Doug.
You're a troublemaker.
See you next week.